So friends, it is very, very important to understand that why do we need cryptocurrencies actually? What is actually the rationale behind these cryptocurrencies becoming so popular that the price of the most famous cryptocurrency, that is Bitcoin, is so high? It is becoming the most sought after digital currency. There should be some reason. So what is the problem? What is the problem with the existing architecture of financial transactions, and which is especially the card money? So what is the problem with the card money? The biggest problem of the card money is the fees which we pay to the middlemen, like credit card companies, banks, and the merchants, and the people who deal with the credit cards. So the foreign exchange dealers, so the especially the international transactions, we really end up paying a lot of middlemen's fees during the international transfer of the money. There is markup fees, and then there is the foreign exchange dealers' fees, and so many fees, so many costs are involved in the middlemen that it makes the use of card money, if not prohibitive, but definitely expensive. The second problem with the card money or the digital money lying with the banks is the security issues. So what has happened is that in all these traditional methods of money transactions and money transfers, you are dealing with card companies, you are dealing with banks, you are dealing with the dealers, money dealers. So they are all the time collecting your data. So you are entrusting your private data to these middle people and these middle entities. Now, these middle entities may not use your data for wrong ends, but these data with them is definitely vulnerable to hackers or possibility of some employees of the companies selling your data, or it is somehow coming into the market, especially at places which are highly undesirable, the so-called deep web, which we are normally, the normal people are not aware of, the dark web and the deep web which internet has, where these kind of data are freely sold and bought. So people are very much vulnerable when they entrust their data to these middlemen, these big companies. And what actually happens with these databases, how this data is protected, how much money are spent or not spent on creating firewalls and saving those data from hackers. So we often hear about so many data breaches and the theft of data, which is very much real. And generally these thefts are for a very large amount of data, and many, many people are affected by these data breaches. The third problem is the accessibility of these instruments, which are mostly based on bank accounts. Now, on this planet, we have almost 2 billion unbanked people in the world. So the people who are not having any access to bank accounts, they find it very, very difficult to transact money, especially in long distances or in international money transfers. So it becomes very, very difficult for them to transact money. And in today's world, where everything is becoming digital, so the unbanked people find it really difficult to survive in the changing environment of e-commerce and social media and the digital commerce. So, you know, it is really, really very, very important that these people who are unbanked, they need to find some ways in their day-to-day transactions of money, that they should be able to use some kind of digital money which does not require the interventions of the banks or the card company or the dealers, money dealers. So that kind of accessibility is very, very important, which is not available, unfortunately, in the card money or the bank money. Now, the other alternative is the cash. Now, what happens with the cash is that cash is a tangible thing. And when cash is a tangible thing, it needs to be physically managed. Now, physical management, movement, safekeeping, and handling of cash is very expensive, require a lot of efforts, require a lot of security. So the tangibility of the cash make it prohibitive to use it on a very mass scale and especially on the long distances. So cash is not the answer in today's world. In today's world of digital transactions, cash is undesirable. Although cash does remove middleman, but it is not practical. So that is the biggest problem with the cash. So there comes the question of finding some way out of transacting money on long distances and probably also for day-to-day financial transactions, which is decentralized. It is not monopolized by a single authority or single company or single bank. It is not entrusted based on trust of the users. And most importantly, it is digital in nature. So the decentralized form of some kind of currency, which is secure, which is safe, which is digital, and which is affordable, the services of which is affordable. So that kind of currency could be the answer. So this has been felt time and again in the past, and that is how the idea of cryptocurrencies and digital money comes in to the picture. So what does cryptocurrencies provide to the people? First very important thing is that it is decentralized in nature. So it avoids the problem of middleman. It avoids the problem of a central authority which controls your financial transactions, which collects your private data and the data which is vulnerable to theft, the data which is vulnerable to breaches. So the decentralization is a very unique feature of cryptocurrencies, that there is no central authority owning the platform where your money is parked. And secondly, very important thing is that it is the digital mode of money transactions. So it avoids the problem of tangibility. So it becomes more and more practical in today's world of digital commerce and online business. So the second very important feature of the cryptocurrency is that it is digital in nature. Thirdly, it is very much accessible. It is available OTC, over the counter. Anyone having access to internet on desktop or even mobile can access cryptocurrency. Fourth, very, very important part of cryptocurrencies, the feature of cryptocurrencies, that the cryptocurrencies are highly secure. It is highly anonymous in nature. It keeps the private and personal data very, very secure. Although in the recent past, due to government objections and their inability to regulate cryptocurrencies, the cryptocurrency based data is also becoming non-private in nature, and governments want these identities to be verified, and only verified user can use cryptocurrencies. So these issues of security are still erupting in cryptocurrencies also.